Hey there everybody, this is Benjamin Blodgett. I'm here to show you today how to download and install the BMod 1.5 for Mac. This is a follow-up video to one of my earlier ones on general usage of the BMod. So let's just get right into it. First, we're going to go to portal2backstock.com, which is my website for my portal projects, and we're going to go to the Ben and August's extended editor and the GitHub page from there. Now here's where you'd normally install for Windows, but we're gonna pop over to the code tab, and here you can see I've just added a new script that makes it a lot easier to install for Mac just 25 minutes ago. So let's go ahead and download the zip file. Downloaded quickly, good. So let's go ahead and find that and extract it. Mac extracted the file, and here we go. We've got this script, but now to actually install it, we're gonna need to open up the terminal. For you who don't know how to use the terminal, I'll give you some pointers here. You can use CD, change directory, and we're gonna put in the tilde there and make sure we're in there. User file. LS lists all the file, and now we're going to go into downloads. You can always press tab to autocomplete what you're typing. So now we're going to open up the BMod master folder. Now that we're here, we just need to run the script, BMod Mac installer.h. Now, if this didn't work for you, if it said you didn't have enough permissions, you just need to change the permissions. You got to mod the permissions on this file. So that's chmod plus x, and then the script's name. So dot slash, and then bmodmacinstaller.sh. So now you can rerun the command above. So the BMod should be installed for you. If that's all you needed, you can close the video. But here I'm just going to open up Portal 2, make sure it installed correctly. Skip past all this. I only recently got a Mac, which is how I was able to record this video. So now we're in the editor, and you can see our palette has changed. So let me drag in some of these new items that require some of the custom resources, just so that we can verify that they appear in game. Something else with the custom script. Yep, there we go, is the single portal device. Let's add a button to the pellet emitter to make sure it emits a pellet. Alright, let's run this. Actually, now that I think about it, I didn't need to attach that button because it had auto-enabled or auto-start enabled, but oh well. So now we are in. I'm recording this remotely, so actually I can't move my mouse inside game, but that doesn't matter. We can see that the items are behaving normally, exactly how we'd expect. The resources are all here, and that's it. That's how you install BMod for Mac. Hope you guys enjoyed, and if you have any questions, you can report them on the GitHub issues page. Thanks for watching.